Hi you guys, welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to be doing a Christmas 2020 plan with me and decor haul. Okay guys, so I actually have Christmas movies going on in the background. The kids have decided it's officially Christmas because here in Minnesota, we have so much snow already. And no, this is not normal. Like we usually get a little bit like of a dusting that melts right away, but we have like a foot of snow on the ground and it is slowly melting. We do have a day that is going to be in the 60s here very soon. Minnesota weather will give you whiplash real quick. So I had gone back and forth quite a bit as to how I wanted to record this video for you guys, but ultimately I decided I just wanted to sit down and make it personal and do like a really quick run through of what I'm doing this year, because I know I'm uploading a lot of videos this week for you in preparation for the ultimate Christmas decor reveal. I am so excited to share what I have in store this year, especially with the renovation. I just noticed while editing that my eyeliner is super smudged from blowing my nose, so I hope you guys enjoy that. Patients in the living room think it's going to come together so nicely. So anyway, let's hop into the themes that I have been looking at for this year. So the final reveal for like my theme that I am doing is I want to do silvers, golds, naturals, and emerald green. Just beautiful, deep emerald green. I caught my eye at Hobby Lobby this year and I fell in love. And it wasn't even the ornaments that I saw. I just saw something in emerald green when I was Christmas decor shopping. It struck a chord. I all of a sudden had this huge epiphany and I was like, oh my gosh, that's it. Like that is it. That is the color that I need in this year's color scheme. So typically I will do silvers, golds, and a deep burgundy red. I really love like just rich, deep colors. And I will do like more farmhousey style with the burgundy. But with this emerald green, I probably will still incorporate some really traditional farmhouse pieces, whether it be like the windmill, little ornaments. I think that those are so cute. Or doing more of like the natural colors. So like cotton stems would be a really good example. And I will show you guys like what my Christmas decor bins look like at the end of this. And then again in my Christmas decorate with me, you will see like everything come together and how I lay it out. I just want to show you what my decor looks like. I like to have a couple of themes on hand at all times so that I can switch it out easily. I think that silvers and golds are great to have as a base to any color scheme. In recent years, I've really been loving some of those like smoky blush pink themes. I think that those are beautiful. I've always loved the rose gold, but I always shift towards a more traditional Christmas feel with silvers and golds. And yes, you can add like blushes and really like pretty accent colors to the silver and gold. Like this year, I'm adding that really beautiful deep emerald green. Anyway, I just love silver and gold as like a traditional Christmas base. So I'm going to share a couple of pictures that have inspired me this year. I'm going to pull up my phone and we're going to go through it together and we're going to kind of talk about what the color scheme. And we're just going to kind of talk about a little bit like how I envisioned like my theme for this year and what I was looking for. I need to switch from my M&M Rustics page. If you guys aren't following our M&M Rustics page, which is our design and DIY blog, we have a Pinterest connected to it, and we also have our blog, and we also have our YouTube channel connected to it. That will all be linked down below for you guys. I actually have a DIY for a barn quilt going live sometime this weekend. I'm hoping for November 1st to have a barn quilt going live for you guys so that you can see how I do some of these little cutesy DIYs around the house. Anyways, make sure that you're following us over there because that is like, I have so many ideas for that channel and for the blog coming up. I just want to share like all of like the deep DIY and design things over there. That's where you're going to get into the nitty gritty. Over here, you're just going to more so see me decorating, but if you want to see how I make something or how I've done something, M&M Rustics is where you want to be. So, all right, going on to my Pinterest, which will also be linked down below for you guys. This year, I was really drawn to Nordic Christmas themes or Scandinavian Christmas themes. I'm actually very Scandinavian, and here in Minnesota, there's so many Scandinavians, like traditional Scandinavians. So I felt like it was such a perfect theme for like my background and for like where I come from. And I just was so drawn to it. So a lot of the Nordic Christmas stuff though can feel kind of cold. It's a lot of like, I'm gonna leave a picture up here, right here for you guys, the one that I'm looking at right now. I'm screenshotting it as I speak. So this one is like very like dark. It's very much so like the evergreens and like those darker like slate colors. Think of like warmer lights with it, and having true evergreens, like very natural looking Christmas, like nothing that's too fluffy and fritzy and like bright red and bright green. It's just very natural, neutral colors. I'm also going to leave a color scheme up here for you guys of what I am doing this year. So if you guys want to mimic it, you guys can take this color scheme palette and run with it as you want to. You don't need to get the exact same items as I have, but if you have that palette, it's so much easier for you to run back and forth to the stores and kind of just keep a good like general scheme in mind. That is something that I have gotten a lot of questions on is, Morgan, how do you decorate? How do you envision it before you have it in the house? Like, how do you do that? And I just plan for a color scheme and I really Pinterest things thoroughly to make sure that I have a theme planned out ahead of time. And I take that color palette with me everywhere. I will be looking for those same colors or repeated patterns, whatever it may be. I want to make sure that it is cohesive throughout the main floor. Moving on to some of the other things that have really inspired me this year, I'm gonna flash a few Pinterest pins that I have been looking at lately that really just sparked my Nordic like base theme for Christmas this year. I wanna say like Nordic farmhouse maybe a little bit. I don't know, I'm doing my own little twist. It's gonna be boho, I feel a little, because I definitely have some really good like natural florals going on, which always gives me that good boho vibe. We just recently started a basket wall, which I'm going to show you guys in this video. Just started a basket wall, which basket walls always feel very boho to me as well. So I'm thinking like lots of like natural dried cranberries and oranges, and we're gonna do all the DIYs to show you guys how to do those and how I personally am going to do them. I plan to do just really full, like beautiful natural greens with the silver and gold, and then with that emerald accent. So again, I'm going to be, I love, like I think one of my most favorite things at night, like when it's Christmas time, and I'm gonna show you guys a picture right here, is when it's just cozy in the home and you have the lighting makes all the difference. I love having Christmas lights strung up across the house. I don't like how they look, so I am trying to incorporate more fairy lights or like hidden lights throughout the house this year to really give the house a good ambiance at night. During this time of year, I just think that it's the ambiance, the lighting is perfect when you have a glass of wine, you get a little charcuterie tray, and you just like have all the things going on, and it just makes my heart feel so full. So anyways, that is definitely something that I am wanting to do this year. For the tablescape this year, I'm going to do it in sections. I do get bored of my tablescapes really fast, I found, and I want them to look different. And with Thanksgiving, like yes, I know the rest of my house is going to be decorated for Christmas, but I'm gonna keep it pretty neutral on the table for Thanksgiving. And then once more of the natural garlands, like the fresh garlands, start coming out, unfortunately I'm limited to when my like local hardware stores and like Target and Walmart start coming out with their fresh garland, or Costco and Sam's, those are really good places to get fresh garland as well for really cheap. I'm limited as to like, you know, when they release those. And a lot of my tablescape, here is a picture of it, my tablescape for Christmas this year, which I'd love to have it for Thanksgiving, but I just don't feel like the fresh garland will last that long. But right here, this is what I'm looking for as far as a fresh garland. And I think that it would make, like, it just makes the house smell so good as well. I wanna incorporate a little bit of fresh. I was trying to find something that was a faux garland that was really close to looking real, and Hobby Lobby just didn't have what I wanted. I am, for now, keeping the garland that is up on the mantle, I think, for Christmas. I want to see how closely it's going to match our new Christmas tree. So anyway, I don't know, I'm just going back and forth. I'm very, very into the naturals this year, as you guys can tell, but I'm limited for that fresh garland as to when it's released. So stay tuned for many parts to this Christmas Decorate With Me. This main one is just going to be getting the tree up and getting the decorations throughout the house, and then I will have a Christmas tree Decorate With Me, and of course more Decorate With Me videos coming as I'm able to get more of these items. So the tablescape I wanted to show you guys before I hop into the haul is this one right here. Now this was a really, really big inspiration for me when it came to something that was a good transition between Christmas and Thanksgiving. That's the thing, is if I'm going to have my tree up, I always decorate early for Christmas, so I'm used to having Christmas decorations up in my house for Thanksgiving. I've been used to it since I was a kid. My mom has always decorated early. Here in Minnesota, our tradition is actually the guys will go deer hunting the first couple weekends of November, and then the ladies will stay home, and we like to decorate for Christmas and get our Christmas baking out and do all of the things. Like, that is how I grew up, is like with my aunts and my grandmas. Like, we would all get together while the guys would be out deer hunting, and then some of us girls will go deer hunting as well. It's just a really good like bonding time, right, for our family. So anyway, this I think is a really good transition between Thanksgiving and Christmas for a tablescape, and is beautiful. I'm loving, like, I love the green and the amber glasses with those naturals and the tapered candles. So just a hint as to what I'm planning for this year. Now let's hop on into my decor haul from my Christmas shop with me last week. I am so pumped to share with you guys what I got this year. Okay, so like I said, I'm so excited for Christmas. We're gonna start decorating today, even though I know Halloween is this weekend. I have to get a head start because I want this video to go live either Sunday or Monday, and it takes me more than a day to decorate for Christmas. So anyways, let's hop on into what I got for this year. I'm just gonna start digging into the pile. So I found these in the natural dried floral section at Hobby Lobby, I believe. I found these for like $5.99 and half off at my Hobby Lobby. And they're just like this really pretty, they've got a little bit of that like cottony look going on with some twine jute on, like, just like on some sticks. But I thought these would be the perfect addition to any of the like arrangements that I have going through the house, or for a center vase, like in a tablescape. I'm not quite sure what I'm gonna do with these guys yet, but we will see. So that was the first thing that I got. Okay, next up on the list, I got these florals from Hobby Lobby. So all of this is part of the Hobby Lobby haul. Most of the stuff I purchased this year is from Hobby Lobby. I haven't gotten a ton of stuff from Target yet because my Target doesn't have a ton of Christmas stuff out yet. So I will save my Target Christmas haul for when my Target is fully stocked. But I got three of these like natural, you see how like beautiful and natural. This is the garland that I was looking for. And actually, if I cannot find a garland that is similar to this, and maybe instead of leaving the one up that I have right now, which is not an evergreen, but it's very similar color to this. I sometimes, for garland, I will just take florals and I will connect them. And I have done that many, 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 many times. When I can't find what I'm looking for in the garland department, I will just make my own with the floral stems. So these were $5.99. These were $4.99 and 50% off. So quite a steal for these. And I think that these are so beautiful. And the quality is so nice. They have these green little berries on there. Absolutely love these. I think I might be sticking these into a vase, like a bottleneck. I'm looking for a really good like bottleneck vase. I'm having some troubles finding a good one right now that doesn't have a blue tint to it. But man, I am on the hunt for an affordable, I don't like spending too much money on like pieces. I like to bargain find. So I'm looking for the perfect price point and for the perfect color, perfect shape vase. which is proving to be a lot harder than I thought it was going to be. So anyways, moving on to the next floral. I picked up two of these, which you would think that these would be more so like a Thanksgiving or fall type of floral, and they definitely are, but trust me you guys, once I have this pulled together, I am going to be probably purchasing a few more of these for my tablescape this year, because I want to incorporate something that is natural for Christmas, like a natural floral Christmas, but also something that is Thanksgiving. So super excited about that find. Moving into the next floral, I got lots of dried florals, guys. I got all of the things. Next up, this is just like a bush in my face. I picked up two of these. This is two bunches in this vase right now. You can't even see my face. I picked up two of these bunches, and they were $11.99 and half off, and the lady was just stocking them in the floral section, and I literally stole them right out of the box she was stocking with. So anyways, I got these for $11.99 and half off, and I actually saw these in one of the pins that I was looking at, so I was just super excited to find these. And yeah, that dried floral section has been so empty lately at Hobby Lobby, so I'm super stoked that I was able to find these. See if I can give you guys a good close-up of these florals. They're so beautiful and just like fluffy looking. I love them. And the vase that they are in, this is actually a hurricane vase from Target that I got for like $11.99. That's one of my hacks, is if you're looking for a decent vase, go to the dollar store or go to the Target candle section, and I've always found like really cute glass vases in that area for pretty cheap. So that was what, this is like one of the only things that I got from Target, but love these dried florals. Next up, you guys, if you've been on my Instagram stories, you know the deal with the pampas grass, okay? All right, so not going to get into it in today's video, but I swear there's like a cult around pampas grass, because who is gonna pay $70 for three stems? A lot of people pay $70 for three stems, but why are they $70? Like, I want to know. I had to switch out batteries, so if I look a little bit different, that is why. But I finally snagged some of the pampas grass. It's been a whole thing, like a whole thing for me. I got these for $10 from Hobby Lobby, okay? Three stems for $10. Much more my speed than $70. These are super sheddy, but they're just the most beautiful, fluffy, like, I love them. I just can't justify $70 for them. But anyways, I need to put these down because they do shed really bad. Somebody told me to hairspray them and they don't shed as bad after that. So anyways, those are the florals that I purchased. And then back to these, these were like $5.99 and half off. Super cheap, and I got two of them. Okay, moving into the next Hobby Lobby purchase. I got two of these wood bead garlands. I thought about doing a DIY for these, and I still might do something similar to put on the tree as a DIY. I just could not find these beads in Hobby Lobby. I can probably find them on Amazon for super cheap, but they're just white and natural colored wood beads, and I plan on incorporating these throughout the house everywhere for Christmas this year. As you can see, there's definitely a color scheme because I've got like the white and then the natural tones. So I got two of these, and these were $14.99 and 50% off. So they're $15 for two of them. Purchase from Hobby Lobby was, this is actually a four pack, but I am down to three right now because one of the kids has decided to steal one. But I'm probably gonna go, I am hoping to go back and purchase a couple more packages of these. I just wanna see how many of these I'm going to need to space them around the tree. I'm probably going to need two more boxes of these, realistically, to kind of give that tree a good like wooded bead look. But loving these, and I think I got these for $4.99 and half off. Next up from Hobby Lobby, I have a couple of these wreaths. I love these. I think that, and these are like really heavy and like nice quality. And these were like $9.99 and half off. So I got them for $5 each. And compared to the Target value section, so for $3, you get this really like spindly wreath. And I love the Target value section. I'm not docking on it at all. I'm just saying that these were a much nicer quality for around the same price. See how much like thicker they are, and they're like grapevine wreath on the back. They're very nice. So if you are looking for smaller wreaths, I would check out Hobby Lobby first, and then I would go over to the Target value section. So, or just buy them all. Buy them all. All right, last thing that I got from Hobby Lobby are the ornaments, which is my accent color for this year, which is this beautiful emerald green. And I'm going to do a clip with all of these together so you can see all of the colors come to life together. I am loving this color. They're real glass, so I'm hoping they last me for more than just this year, but that is wishful thinking. This color I think is so beautiful. I am obsessed with this color, if I can get the camera to focus on it. There we go. This is the color for this year, you guys. This is the accent color. This really, really deep emerald green. Oh my gosh. Even with my shirt, which like my shirt is kind of the same color as some of the things that I'm doing for Christmas this year, like this color is gorgeous. And like, again, with like the pampas grass, like look at that accent color against the naturals. It is so beautiful. Oh, those are shedding so bad. Anyway, so I got two of these packages of the emerald green for $9.99 and half off. So I got both of these for $10. And I think there is, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4 times. So there's a dozen in each one for $5 each. And at my Hobby Lobby, I snagged the last two. The last two that were on the shelf. So pretty pumped about that. Now I am going to hop into the rest of the haul. There's just a couple of more things here. Honestly, I didn't find a whole ton of stuff yet because I want to get my decorations up and then see what I need to fill in before I purchase a ton more stuff. So the only thing that I purchased from TJ Maxx, I have a larger tree like this that I've gotten from Home Goods. As you guys know, TJ Maxx and Home Goods have very similar pieces for Christmas. So, and sometimes I'll find like Matt the things that I'm missing from one store, the other store will have. So like I said, I have a bigger version of this exact tree from Home Goods, and I got this smaller one for $7.99 from TJ Maxx. And then from Target this year, I showed you guys the hurricane vase that I purchased. That was like $11.99. And then I got these. These were from the Hearth and Home, the Magnolia section. And I believe I got these for $3.99. These are just unscented tapered candles. And I had the hardest time finding tapered candles that fit my candle holders. And these candle holders are from Hobby Lobby, in case you're wondering, that I purchased a long, long time ago. But these used to be up on my mantle, and I brought them down to put them on my table because I plan to do lots of really pretty candle holders on my table for Christmas this year. The last two things that I got for Christmas decor this year so far, these last two items are from Walmart, and I got them for $4.88 each. I am obsessed with these. These are so cute. I got, they have like little like twine, like jute hangers on top with these like little tiny wooden beads on the like very tippy top of them. And this one says go tell it on the mountain, and it's like a thick like cardboard paper with the wood on top and bottom. And I think that these are so beautiful, and they go so well with the theme here, with the natural color scheme that we're going with. I think that this font and just everything about it, is just so perfect for this year's theme. And again, $4.88, you cannot go wrong. The next one that I picked up was Silent Night, definitely one of my most favorite Christmas songs, or hymns, or whatever you want to call it. I got the Silent Night. It has like the lyrics and the notes on there. It's so pretty, and I love it so much. And definitely the color. This one is much thinner. It's a different material. This one is like a, oh gosh, what is this called? I can't think, it's not canvas. Maybe it's canvas. Yeah, this is a canvas. This is canvas, but like a softer canvas. And it has the wood again on top and bottom and the same little jute hanger with the beads on top. And this one was also $4.88. All right, my kids are losing their patience with me, so I am going to scoot. I hope you enjoyed this Christmas plan with me and Christmas decor haul for 2020. I'm so excited to be sharing my Christmas decor with you guys this year. If you're new to my channel, I do all kinds of decorating and motivational and cleaning videos here on my channel. And I would love if you considered subscribing and joining my little tribe here on YouTube. I am now doing YouTube full time and it has just been the most amazing experience, and I love creating content for you guys and being real and giving you all the design ideas and being a hot mess and all of the things. Okay, all right, the kids really want some goldfish, so I am going to skedaddle, but I will see you on Friday for a day in the life. Okay, bye guys. Also, my eyeliner was like crazy for part of that video, so you're welcome. All right, so this is the start of my basket wall. I still have a couple more I need to add on to like elongate it to really fill out this space. But this is what we have so far. And I think that it accents the green on this wall so well. I still need to finish up doing the side walls green, but and I'm super pumped to see what it's going to look like with all of the Christmas decor up in here as well.